Newly appointed Senate Minority Leader Reynold Nessebe started the session with three priorities: a balanced budget, protecting privacy, and focusing on what he calls real issues.
We want to talk about issues that matter to South Dakotans. We have a child care crisis in South Dakota. We have a long-term care crisis in South Dakota. We have too many people that are addicted to drugs that need access to care and rehabilitation. We need to address our mental health crisis here in South Dakota as well.
Action on mental health is one of the wins for state Democrats this session. 10 of the 11 Democrats serving in Pierre signed on to a bipartisan bill funding suicide prevention programs. It passed both chambers with a veto-proof two-thirds majority. Another victory was a bill with bipartisan support aimed at preventing fentanyl overdoses. Senate Minority Leader Nessebe and Republican Assistant House Majority Leader Representative Taylor Rehfeldt sponsored that bill. It passed through both chambers by the middle of session.
In terms of making government work better, I'm proud to say that HB 1041 is on the governor's desk. So this is a bill for fentanyl test strips, to decriminalize those so that someone who is using drugs can use a fentanyl test strip to find out whether it's laced with fentanyl. We have too many overdoses in South Dakota, and this is a harm reduction strategy. It had broad bipartisan support, and I'm hopeful that the governor is going to sign this and that this is going to save lives.
Governor Noem did sign the bill, which becomes law later this year. But Democrats could not defeat legislation to ban certain medical and surgical procedures for transgender youth. It continues a trend focusing legislation on transgender rights. This year, as lawmakers debated House Bill 1080, Assistant Minority Leader Representative Aaron Healey pointed out that many proponents of the bill who testified in committee were not even South Dakota residents.
Well, proponents couldn't find anyone in South Dakota who transitioned as a minor and detransitioned. And that makes me wonder why we're talking about this today in our body. What really bothers me were the two proponents who did show up from out of state. They are doing a tour of state legislatures right now. They were in Montana last week with the same message.
Other Democrats say the bill is discriminatory, adding it will be the focus of lawsuits, cost taxpayers money, and drive families out of the state.
A very similar bill that came about in Arkansas is currently at over $2.5 million. In litigation costs. So I'm not asking you to pick a side. I'm not asking you to make a decision about our trans youth and their families. I'm asking you to think about South Dakota taxpayers.
Where's the parent in all this? The parents are supporting their children who are trying to determine who they are as a true self. So by passing this legislation, we are taking away parental rights, rights that a parent has with their child and with medical professionals.
Despite these arguments, all but three Republicans in the House voted for the bill. The Senate passed the measure as well, and Governor Noem signed it within hours. Democrats faced another defeat in the House when lawmakers voted against Senate Bill 191. The bill would have created a task force to address the disproportionate number of Native American children in the state's foster care system. It was a joint effort between Democratic Senator Red Dawn Foster and Representative Puri Poirier, who worked with tribal leaders. It passed the Senate, but not the House. Leaders from four of the state's nine sovereign tribes condemned the House decision. Puri Poirier is the House Minority Whip. We spoke earlier this month.
We have to come together. There's no way around it. We have to come together and deal with this issue together. And we have to understand the baseline knowledge that, yes, there's a political jurisdiction here. Yes, tribes have a responsibility in this, and so does the state have a responsibility in this, because we are dealing with Native children, which is the future of South Dakota. I am tired and I am heartbroken over the odds and over the statistics that Native people hold in this state. Poverty. Poverty looks a lot like neglect. South Dakota has six of the 10 poorest counties in all of the United States. And those six counties are all in tribal reservations. Poverty to incarceration is a cycle that we have to break. And it's not just going to take one people, it's going to take all people.
That work is likely to continue in future legislative sessions. Despite these high-profile defeats, Democrats shared in the celebratory attitude that accompanied the general budget in the session's final hours. House Minority Leader Orrin Lesmeister thanked his colleagues across the aisle before praising this year's budget investments.
You know, folks, we're sitting here on a historic day when we just passed the largest tax cut in the history of South Dakota. But yet on top of that, we're given CSPs, nursing homes, critical care providers, schools, and we're just at the same time being fiscally responsible yet, as we always have been here in South Dakota. In my 7 years of being in this body, I have never seen these numbers, never. And yet we're gonna pass this forward and really set the tone for the future.